Let's bring in the UCLA head coach, Steve Alford. Hi, Coach. How are you?
Very good, Dan. How are you?
I'm good, but I have a question. I have a lot of questions for you. I just I saw an analytics site, 538, that said the Warriors can be the greatest team of all time, depending on how much they win by. If they win the finals, how much they win by. Could you look at Golden State and say that's the best team I've ever seen?
That's hard, because I think you get into eras again, Dan, so that becomes hard. Like I've always said, I was very blessed. I played Indiana high school basketball when it was just one class. You know, now they have class basketball, and I'm so glad I grew up in an era where we just had one state title winner out of 350 schools, so no three-point line. You know, so different eras, I think, produce different ways of playing the game, and I do think they're playing the game under the rules that we have now and the era that we have now as well as anybody. It's impressive to watch.
But are we too reliant on the three?
Well, I think that's a big, big part of what they do. It was a big part of what we did here at UCLA last year. I think it has to do with your personnel and their personnel. They have a lot of guys that can make shots, so you might as well take more shots where you get a bonus point for it. They know how to spread the floor, and I think they're very underappreciated, too, of how they defend, too. I think what they do defensively has been very good as well.
But if you're going to look at Golden State, and I always say this to people, if you're coaching, you know, little kids, if you're coaching high school kids, you're coaching college, have them look at how long the Golden State players have the ball. And
right.
But why don't other teams do this? Even though you don't have Durant and Curry and Klay Thompson and Draymond Green, the ability to get a better shot, a wide open shot, increases with the amount of ball movement that you have, but it doesn't feel like that's being taught now. Why?
Absolutely. And, you know, I played for one of the best, Coach Knight, and most of my playing career for him was back in the day with a 45-second shot clock, but so we passed it probably more than what most teams do, but it always finds a way to get back to the guys that can make the right shots and right plays. But he always said a huge key to offense was spacing and ball movement. And when the ball can move and you've got the appropriate spacing, I think you're hard to guard. And I think that's why they're hard to guard. They know that they're going to get – everybody's going to get the touches because nobody holds it. You don't see – very seldom do you see Golden State in any kind of ISO situation – to where it's just Durant or it's just Curry or it's just a one player holding the ball. And now I've always felt like that was the easiest thing to defend. What's hard to defend is when that ball's hopping.
He's Steve Alford joining us, Continental Tire Coach's Corner. Did you play against Jordan?
I played with him and against him. I played against Michael in college. Then we played on the same 84 Olympic team. And then I was 4 years in the league. I didn't get a lot of tick other than the run at Golden State, so didn't face him as much. The one time I do remember facing him was in the old Chicago Stadium, and Derek Harper was my teammate with the Mavericks, and I was put in at a timeout, and Paxson and Jordan were on the court at the same time, and I like tackled Paxson, and I said, hey, no disrespect, but I'm guarding you. I'm not guarding the other guy. And Jordan makes a pass to the wing, and I hear Derek Harper yell switch, and I see who I'm getting ready to switch to, and I yell switch back. So I took great pride in trying to stay off of posters when I played in the NBA.
Can you make any comparison? I know it's generational, but can LeBron be in the conversation with Michael Jordan? Will we ever allow it?
Well, I hope so, because and I've always been the biggest proponent of Michael because I still think he's the best that's ever played the game. But I do think this era is much, much more critical in their evaluation of LeBron than was done in Michael's era, I think. What LeBron has done has been unbelievable, especially in this era with the balance and just how many good players there are to get the seven straight finals.
Yeah.
And to do that in this era with different teams. He did it with – you're looking at doing it with Cleveland, then Miami, then back to Cleveland. It's just an unbelievable feat that I think he's doing. And night in, night out, He's very durable. He just does what he does, and I think being a superstar and being a great teammate as far as the other, he just can beat you in a lot of different ways, and that's a special trait.
The Lonzo Ball, LeVar Ball situation, it felt like LeVar Ball came onto the scene late during the season, at least nationally, and then, of course, blew up here in the offseason. But how much interaction did you have with him coaching Lonzo this past year?
Well, really zero. LeVar's never been a distraction, you know, to us. I think that was established in the recruiting process that that's all part of it. You know, we do the coaching, and you got to put your trust in us that we're going to do what's best for your son. So LeVar was great. Never got a phone call, was never at practice, was never a distraction to our team at all. You know, we would see him every now and then on TV saying something, and I can remember, you know, Lonzo and others, you know, just laughing at comments, and then they just go about doing their job. And Lonzo is just a terrific player. He's a very special talent and can beat you in a lot of ways. He can beat you on the backboard. He can beat you defensively. I swear there was a game against Riverside this year where he showed up and he wasn't going to take a shot. And he was just going to try to get 20 assists, and he nearly did both of those things. So he's just a very, very special talent. But the thing I'll appreciate most is how he went about his job.
Wait, he told you that he was going to get 20 assists?
No, he never told us that. But when you watch the game live, I can remember talking to my assistants, you know, on the bench and saying, I don't think Lonzo's going to take a shot in this game. I think he's literally going to try to win this game without taking a shot. Very similar to what he did in the McDonald's All-American game, if you can remember that game. I think he set a McDonald's All-American record for assists, but only took like two or three shots. And I think he ended up taking three shots in that Riverside game, and that was because he had a couple breakaway layups and he had no choice. But he set, I think, our single-game assist record for a freshman in that game.
Do you think NBA players are going to go after him because of his dad?
That's a tough one, Dan, because I was a player once. I was in those locker rooms a long time ago, and I know how competitive it is, and I know it's really the first time the game becomes a business more than it is. You know where you're going to play, and you know who you're going to play with, and the player has some kind of say and stuff. The majority of the talent in the NBA doesn't have a say, and you have to do – it becomes a business. So that's a tough one. I think the more people that get around Lonzo will see what kind of player he is and what kind of person he is, and those attributes that Lonzo have are very, very good because he's a great person and he's a great player.
Why did we have you going to Indiana like it was a foregone conclusion?
I don't know. I said that in the beginning that you know, I was on that last national championship team in 87 and grew up there, played there, had a phenomenal run as a player. But it's weird. We all get older, but I've been out of the state now nearly 24 years almost. And
wow.
I still go back. Father's Day, we have a camp at Franklin College with my dad. We've had the Alford basketball camp there since 1986, and it's still sold out and doing great. And it's a lot of fun, and, you know, that is always home. But, you know, being at UCLA is something that, wow, it just doesn't get any better than that. It's a tremendous blessing to be on this sideline.
But Indiana did offer you the job, right?
No. It never got to that.
Did you get a raise this offseason?
We're in negotiations. Things are in negotiations.
Damn, yeah,
right,
you had to give money back, Steve. I hope they gave you money back this time around.
Well, that is the hope, Dan. That is the hope, and taking care of my staff is a hope because I'm very blessed. I've got a tremendous staff.
All right, now can you be honest in this last question? Markelle Fultz, Lonzo Ball, better player?
Well, yeah, there obviously there's probably a bias, but you know, there was two games that we played, one up in Seattle, and then one here in Los Angeles where Markelle did not play. So it was only one head-to-head matchup, and that was in Seattle. And, you know, we won in a lopsided game, and Lonzo was terrific. So I obviously saw Lonzo more than Markelle. I think you're looking at two outstanding guards. Markelle's more of a scorer, but Lonzo can score. And Lonzo probably didn't get enough credit for, you know, he made over 60 threes as a freshman, shooting 41%. And a lot of people don't talk about that because of the way he shoots it. But he gets it to the right point. It's just a different path, and he makes shots. But I think as far as a player, if I had to pick a player that would change my team the most, the quickest and in the most positive ways, it would be Lonzo.
Have fun in the off season there. Tell your dad it said hello. Hope the basketball camp goes well there, Steve.
I'll definitely do that, Dan. Thanks a lot for having me on.
All right. That's Steve Alford, UCLA head coach. Continental Tire, Coach's Corner. Steve Alford, Continental Tire, the exclusive tire of the Dan Patrick Show. No matter where you drive, what you drive, Continental designs tires for what you do. For more information, visit ContinentalTire.com. Continental Tire for what you do.
The Dan Patrick Show, weekday mornings on Audience.